and help themselves rather than relying on government, whose resources are finite, then we'll be more prosperous. If you take your mind back to the 70s, you know, a lot of schools were built by village communities. Roads were made by village communities. Electrification exercises were carried out in the villages, all through self-help development. So we cannot continue, you know, to wait for other people to do things for us. When we say people should contribute, you know, and do something for a person, people say, oh, why not just go to one organization? One organization, if you just ask them, they will just give you all the money. But you should always realize that that one organization you're always talking about is human beings that are contributing to make that organization viable. Why can't the Global be viable so that we'll be supporting other lesser organizations? Well, look at the quality of the people here. We have the means, we have the resources. You know, so please, let's join hands together and work and make sure that for posterity, we'll leave a legacy, a foot in the sands of time. That during our time, this is what we did for our fatherland and our motherland, and for the future generation yet to come. I think I will end there and go straight to the goodwill message from the organizer. We invited a lot of people, I sent the secular out to say, we didn't just invite people because we want to invite people. We invited those we think will have an impact, will have something to say. Then we invited the governor, the Obanoba, the chief justice of Edo State. But like I said in that circular, we did not invite anybody from the State House of Assembly. Because in January, when we were sending out letters, people were fighting among themselves. Honorable members were fighting and using battle axe in the House of Assembly. So, however, let me quickly read this goodwill message. I think everybody has got a copy. Listen, goodwill message by the Omonoba Nendo Okorakpagbapo Oba Eyeyawo, Commander of the Federal Republic, Oba of Benin, to the Edo Global Organization Annual Conference, holding in Barcelona, Spain, from the 18th to the 20th of June. I thank the organizers for inviting me to this auspicious conference. I appreciate your invitation, but owing to pressing Paris commitments, I will not be chanced to personally attend. I, however, have sent two of my senior chiefs, GSO Obamoyi, Erisel Benin, and GVO Zamiri Obadolaye Obini, respectively, to make my presence felt in the event. So, to continue with the goodwill message, the Oma said, I'm particularly pleased when I hear of the well-being of our sons and daughters abroad, more so when they come together to deliberate on issues concerning development of their state and communities back home. The theme of this year's conference, mobilizing Edo people for participative governance and self-led development, is apt, timely, and most relevant to the present participatory democracy in our country. Deliberations on this important subject will no doubt engender desired need for development in our state, in particular, and country generally. Also captivating are the topics slated for discussion at the conference, which are economic empowerment and job creation, development of medium-level industries, stemming migration from the state, and preventing human trafficking, fund generation, amongst others. These are some of the major issues bordering our minds in Edo State. I'm therefore gratified to hear that they are also the concern of our sons and daughters abroad, and are subjects of brainstorming on how to help tackle them to our overall advantage. It is my hope that deliberations and resolutions at this conference
will not merely end on paper and roundtable discussions, but will be translated to make meaningful and practical impact on the lives of our people, especially those involved in the most abhorred human trafficking. Let us remind ourselves of the popular Benin adage, Userase Ure, where no Urea, Userasu Ure, Egiwuye Ugongore. Simply translated in English parlance, the adage says, when a snail is poor and hunger stricken, it dies in its shell. I think that is very deep. But the lesson that the Benin person derives from the saying is that a well-bred and determined someone would rather go hungry or prefer to pack his way than take food or arms from another who will sneer, snore, and debase him on mere asking. This, therefore, should instantly instill in all of us that the time has come when all hands must be on deck in whatever human endeavors we are individually or collectively engaged to move our state and people forward. We should all eschew the arts of laziness and over dependency on any government or on whatever masters you have. We should at all times be creative, productive, and industrious in order to have whatever choice of food on your table. While our present government back home is working assiduously to provide good job opportunities, infrastructural development, security, and peace to ensure the well-being of our people in the entire Edo State, I implore you all to kindly support it in order to actualize its laudable aspirations. Your wealth of experience and transfer of your individual technology to meet the needs and social satisfaction for all and sundry in the state will be deeply appreciated and commendable. Let me at this juncture advise you that Edo State is fast becoming devoid of all social vices that have scared many of you away from coming home to invest in your towns or cities. We have recently taken our last resort and compelling steps to evoke traditional causes on any evildoer who will not desist from making the state and country uncomfortable and unprogressive for well-meaning and peace-loving citizens like most of you in the diaspora. Please, feel free now to come home and enhance the ongoing speedy development in our state in all its ramifications. In conclusion, let me urge you all to continue to be good and law-abiding Nigerians in the foreign countries where you currently stay or do genuine and lawful business. Your relationship with your fellow foreigners should be most cordial and worthy of emulation. I hereby wish you all fruitful and successful deliberations and journey mercies to your respective destinations at the end of the conference. May God and our ancestors bless you. Signed, Omonoba Nendo, Omonoba Ediawa, Oba of Benin.